carver for things like doors. I think it's stone carver. All right, embark. Preparing map. Okay, so. A dwarven outpost, you have arrived. After a journey from the mountain homes into the forbidding wilderness beyond. Your harsh trek has finally ended. Your party of seven is to make an outpost for the glory of all low-tech Rumek. There are almost no supplies left, but with stout labor comes sustenance, whether by bolt, plow, or hook. Provide for your dwarves. You are expecting a supply caravan just before winter entombs you, but it is spring now, enough time to delve secure lodgings ere the wolves get hungry. A new chapter of dwarven history begins here at this place. Zanekog, Relic Boot, Strike the Earth. Okay, we're paused. We came with a horse and a camel. We're going to murder them promptly. Get everybody else underground. Couple things you do. Couple things you do when you start. For me personally, and I know a lot of other people who play like this, when I start the game, I always start paused, and there's several things that I have to do before I do anything else. I need to go to hunters, and I need to say nobody does this. Then I need to go fisher dwarves. Nobody does this. Uncheck this guy. He's not fishing. Nobody's fishing. Right? Go to miners. We need to designate another miner. It's going to be the doctor. The doctor doesn't have anybody to heal for the first little while where you're at the base, so he might as well be a miner. So now we have four miners, and we have a woodcutter, which is Mamuz. We designated him already. He gets the one axe that we come with. So now that we've designated everybody here, we want to go to work orders. Just kidding. We want to go to labor again and go to kitchen. We want to go ingredient type plump helmets. We want this to be brewed. We don't want it to be cooked, so we're going to turn that off. All this stuff is fine. Once we get pigtails, we're going to need to come in here and turn pigtail brewing off, because we're going to be making clothes out of that. One of the other things we're going to do is we're going to go to standing orders, and then we're going to go to chores, and then we're going to go to burial and refuse. Children are not going to be hauling trash or body parts or bodies in any way, shape, or form. But we'll do that. Go to other. Everybody harvests. No, not everybody harvests. Only farmers harvest. Only farmers harvest. Mix similar foods in barrels. That's fine. Preferred zones for water drinking. Preferred zones for fishing. Really, I don't care about these because nobody fishes or drinks from the water. Everybody drinks alcohol except for people who need water at the hospital. And I usually put the well right in the hospital, so they just get it from there. Sieges and forbidding. Forbid all other death items. Claim your dead, claim your death items, claim other dead. Forbid floor and wall cleaning during sieges, yeah. Forbid trap cleaning and rearming during sieges, yes. Forbid cages from being sprung. Forbid cages from sprung traps during sieges, yes. Forbid toppled building items during sieges, yes. Oh yeah, I'm getting there. Don't worry, Praxis, I'm getting there. Yo, Rob! First of all, brother, welcome to the stream. I gotta tell you, nothing happened to the last one. We built it so goddamn well that it's gonna continue on as that civilization's mountain home pretty much indefinitely. We left it with all the best thing. It was worth almost $3 million. There were several crazy technological systems in there. It was a great fort. And I hope that it lives on forever in that world. And I do want to go back to that world and continue playing that world at some point. For now, we're on a new world. because we're feeling fresh and brand new. And we're just trying to figure out what we're going to be saving and keeping. So workers save corpses. No, workers dump corpses. Yes. Workers save skulls. Workers save bones. Workers save shells. Workers save skins. Yeah, so we can make leather for sure. Hair and wool. Other objects, no. Dump other objects. Ignore outdoor refuse. Workers gather refuse. Ignore outdoor vermin rain, of course, yes. Hauling. Workers gather animals, food, all this doesn't change. Automatically weave all thread. I'm going to leave this on for now. But as soon as I have a loom, I will come back and as soon as I set up the clothing network, the industry, I will change these. And again, Admiral Praxis makes a very important point here. The most suicidal thing that needs to be changed, automatically collect webs. This means the moment that you crack open the caverns, your clothiers will jet downstairs as fast as they can and just run off into the fucking caverns like madmen. So no automatic web collection. I usually don't turn that on until after I've secured several safe areas, and I can turn it on and then turn the burrow on so they only get the webs from the burrowed areas. That's the only way that I use that. Slaughter any marked animal, yes. Automatically butcher carcasses, yes. Automatically clean fish, automatic kitchen and tannery, yes, yes. Okay, that's everything there. Do I need to do anything? Noble, here we go. Don't show again. There's a lot of that, like they were saying earlier. Military commander is our competent tactician. The chief medical dwarf is the doctor. The broker is the expedition leader. The bookkeeper is the expedition leader. The manager is the expedition leader. I think that for now, the militia commander is also going to be the sheriff. And, why doesn't it show me what the sheriff does when I highlight my cursor over him? What is the difference between... I'm going to have to go look this up now. Yo, the spaghetti was excellent. Give me a... I need to catch up on chat, man. I've been doing a bunch of talking and not a bunch of reading. Maybe social skills for the miner? Maybe he can entertain people when he goes on breaks. That's what a good idea. We should have done that. How many skulls is set to stockpile? I do have skulls set to stockpile for my current embark, but I often dump them. I can understand. When I'm grooming a starter for a militia, I usually go for a tactician teacher. Yeah, I read that, I think. Yeah, I read that too. Whether or not I do skulls hinges on whether or not I do birds. Can understand that. Yo, Smooth Sailing, welcome to the stream, brother. Judge of intent or negotiation trait for the broker? I don't know if I grabbed that or not. Birds are the best source of skulls. I really go nuts trying to remember mason versus stonecutter versus stonecarver. Yeah, but I think I finally got it down. They all changed from OG Dwarf Fortress, which makes it even more fun. Oh, geez. A couple of things you do. Click don't show again a lot. Yeah, that's for sure. You definitely do that a lot. What happened to Fort Number 10? Oh, yeah, I did read that, and I did say we retired it. It's still alive and well. Suicidal thing, you're definitely right there. Spaghetti was delicious. Sheriff is baby captain of the guard, I think. You don't need to set them all up right away. And no laws too soon. We're life simulation dwarves, bro. I would never forget about you guys. Never. Yeah, I think that's where we're going to stop for now in terms of those guys. Few things that we have to do on the surface right in the beginning. They kind of do it already for you, but the first thing I like to do is create a little zone about where everybody's standing. Click accept, and it's just a standard meeting area. And it'll just say like that. What's up, buddy?
If you're just gonna go up there and put the pot pie in the thing, I just stayed on here.
Better yet, you can go read what's on the, what it says to set it to on the pot pie, and you can put it in the oven yourself. And then you can set a timer in the bedroom so that you can go up and get it out of the oven, and you can let us know when dinner's done.
I would do that.
Yeah?
Yeah. I could be the one cooking dinner.
Well, all you gotta do is set the oven and slide it in the oven. It's super easy. Set it and forget it. But you gotta set an alarm. You gotta read the instructions and set an alarm. Okay. Why don't you go upstairs and read the instructions on it, come back downstairs, let me know how long it needs to cook and what temperature. Go up there and look now.
Okay. This is for you.
Cool. Put it on the fridge, man. Fridges are where drawings go.
And my wall.
I'm a halfling? Nice. On that note, I need some plump helmets, please. Yo, I'll tell you guys what. Whoever's watching, if you want a dwarf, you don't have to pay the 5K. Just because we're like in the beginning. Like, if you want a founding dwarf, just like type a 1 in chat and I'll put your name on a dwarf. So yeah, we start with a little area there. We'll do a animal training area as well. Like that. Nice. Okay, we got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. There's one more slot. Bert got it. All right. If there's one named Burr, add a T for me. Okay. All right, let's go and see. There's no Burrs, so we'll just make a Bert. But that's, yeah. So, Minkont the Miner. The Miner. Who's the first one in chat to say something? Smooth Sailing. Smooth Sailing has been in every fort almost every fort I've created, I think. And in our last fort, he was a fucking he was a militia commander and he was a fucking beast. He killed like several forgotten beasts. Your Smooth Sailing. Wait, was it? There was 3 O's. And then we got Admiral Praxis. And then we got Nevius. I'm just kind of going down the line. I hope that's okay, guys. I don't mean to not assign you the dwarf you want. Remember, the T is silent, so I'm just gonna leave it off. Oh. Hello?
Yeah.
Hey, come down here and tell me. Brian. Save the echo for when Graham needs it. Because when it goes off, I think that Graham needs me and I need to go upstairs. So just come down and let me know. Thank you, buddy. Echo, hang up. Echo, hang up. Echo, hang up. Jesus Christ, that thing is... It's okay, the one you gave me is good. Gotcha. The T is silent until it's not. That's awesome. Okay, so you're done. Carpenter, who is next on the list? Wolfie. Just do Wolfie. Well, we'll do the underscore P99, whatever. And then we'll do, is this the Chief Medical Dwarf? Chief Medical Dwarf will be... Let me go up here. Orchid. Butenchi Orchid. I don't know if I can put Chief Medical Dwarf Butenchi Orchid in there. So I'm going to put CMD for Chief Medical Dwarf, and then we'll do Butenchi Orchid. Is that how you spell that? M-U-T-E-N-C-H-I? M-U-T-E-N-C-H-I? Oh, M-U-T-E-N-I-C-H-I. Mutanichi Orchid. Okay. Then... Yes?
There were no steps to it. It's just, it just says chicken pot pie.
It just says chicken pot pie.
Yep. Like it's price and blonde and list.
Obby, you are the expedition leader. And then last but not least, the militia commander is Bert. I mean, like, technically speaking, you could be Stinthad Irith Bert Soul. Like, if you wanted me to, instead of Biss, I could put Bert in there. Because you said you wanted to slide a Bert into a name. So we could do that if you wanted. Chief Medical Dwarf Orchid, we're all gonna die. Yeah, that's good. All right. So this will be... Oh, man, it's gonna delete it. It's gonna delete it, though, as soon as I click it. Oh, dude, I can't do that because I don't know... I'm not gonna have the... It's not gonna be the same. Hey, stay here. I'll get to you in a second. Patience is a virtue, son. We'll just do militia, and instead of commander, you'll be the Bertmander. Militia Bertmander. There you go. All right, now you want to set the oven to 350 degrees, and you want to cook it. How big is it? It's pretty wide. It's pretty big. Okay.
The circumference is.
We probably want to do 40 minutes at 350, but you want to set a timer for 30 minutes. And if you go up there and look at it, and the top of the pot pie, like the pastry part that goes on the top of the pot pie, if it's like more than golden, like it's like starting to look like it's starting to get a little burnt, pull it out. But if it still looks like it's not golden at all, then let it cook for another 10 minutes.
I'd say I'd put it.
So what did I tell you? How many degrees?
Yeah, 40 minutes.
For 40 minutes, and how long are you going to set the timer for? 30 minutes, and you're going to check it. And if it needs another 10, you're going to give it another 10, and if it's done, you're going to pull it out. And what does it look like if it's done?
Like, golden, but almost burnt. Really burnt?
Yes. Oh, hold on. See this right here? Yeah. You know, it's like darker color than the rest of these. These are what they should look like. This is what it is bad. So you want to get it when it looks like that. See how like the edges are like golden and it's still like yellow in the middle kind of?
Yeah.
That's what you're looking for.
Should I just put it at 350 and put it in immediately, or should I wait until it's like hot?
If you want to put it right in the oven, then set the timer for 35 minutes before you check it. So you give it 5 minutes to heat up. So like if you put it right in, set your timer for 30. So do it 35 minute timer in the bedroom, and then set it at 350 and put it right in. And it's going to cook for about 40 minutes, which means if you want to eat between 5:30 and 6, that you need to put it in the oven in about 45 minutes.
I would put it.
So yeah, go to bedroom. Go to the bedroom. Set a timer for 45 minutes, and then go chill in your room till it's time to go do it. And then you can come ask me whatever questions you want.
Should I put it back in the fridge?
Is there anything covering it? Is there plastic covering it?
I don't know if I closed it.
Is it in a box or is there plastic over it?
There's plastic. Plastic.
You didn't rip the plastic off it, did you?
No.
Then it's... Go put it back. Just go put it back and then go sit. And set your timer. Don't forget, 45 minutes. Oh, okay, let me catch up. Oh my god, there's so much going on. Stop saying Wolfie, you got it right once? Alright, Wolf it is. Cashiers should have chairs. There's no good reason they don't. I agree. It may not be easy, but we can handle it. Yep, I'm sure. I saw cashiers with chairs in Germany, and I think it's an American thing to force people to stand all day. I don't know why. It might just be because it's cheaper to not get chairs and make people stand. This fortress will be gorgeous. It will. I'll keep all the bears in line. Excellent. Interesting. I realized that everywhere I was in Europe and Ukraine, cashiers were sitting, and the only place I saw standing ones was in American movies. Yeah. Yeah, I seriously don't remember why they forced people to stand to work there. It makes no sense to me. It makes no sense to me either. Good question. I saw a European cashier in a music video, and I thought... I had her sitting in the scene because... Oh. Dang, dude. Just tell him you're not eating unless you can read. If you're not suffering, it's not work. That's true. Yeah, man. Chat does that sometimes. Okay, we're still talking about things that you do when you start the game. We set up the... Here, we're going to do a little sonar. Going to go here. Workshops, farming, farm plot. Let's just do a big one. As big as it'll go. Okay, we've got the start of a cavern layer here. And nothing underneath of it. Interesting. Okay, let's go back to the surface. Let's dig a furrow over here. A farming farm plot. Okay, let's go down. See what this really looks like. Okay. Ooh, that's a pretty open area, chat. Okay. So we're going to need to path under this cavern layer. So, for sure. Is it back in the fridge?
Yep.
Thank you. Let's begin the construction and mining, Commander. Absolutely. First step, mine. First thing I learned to cook was a hot dog in the microwave. It happened, yeah. I think the first thing I learned how to cook was pancakes. I didn't know you could use parm pots like that. You might have a chasm, or is it wood floor? No, it's a farm plot, and you just go down, and it'll show you where you can build a farm plot and where you can't. So, like, right here, we know for sure, right here, there's a cavern floor. What I don't know is if there's water around it, or if there's a chasm above it. What I do know is I am, if this is 18... I am on 35, so it needs to go down an incredible distance, which makes me kind of want to start my downward slope, like right over here, right? So we did like 5 wide. That's my standard. That's where I go. That's just where I like to keep. I just like to keep it 5 wide. If it needs to go down to 3 to path between certain areas, I'll take it to 3, but I always do 5. And this is farther than where I normally start. One of the big things I usually do, chat, is I try to put my ramp as close as possible to my wagon. So they get up to the surface, they grab what they need, and they fuck off immediately. But this time we're a little different. We know that there's going to be a cavern layer, and I kind of want to dig down towards the center, where more in the center, and if I give myself maybe 10 tiles to go down, I'm going to end up being closer with my main path to that open area, where, and I want to be there, because I'm going to have to wall off that area and utilize it for myself. I worked in a grocery store when I was a teenager, and it's definitely not chair cost. My roommate at the time was a checker with a back injury whose doctor said she's not allowed to stand for more than 30 minutes at a time. And they offered to buy her own chair for an accommodation. And they told her corporate would not allow anyone a chair. And she had to simply not work for the entire length of her recovery. Wow. Yo, Deep, it's good to see you, brother. Imagine if they rendered what was on the current level, like minus one or minus two layer in the background. Oh, yeah. Listen. American companies are crazy. I remember I once worked a 13 and a half hour swing shift 6 days a week for Tyson Chicken. I sat down and did the numbers one night just to try to calculate is that even legal? I don't know if you're talking to me or Tyson. Tyson's absolutely brutal from what I've heard. Oh man. Listen, I worked at the busiest Tyson Chicken factory on the planet. It was also one of the smallest the company had. So it was a tiny factory where the people were fucking monsters. Like, I'm not playing around. These guys were fucking beasts. I worked 13-hour swing shifts in the blast freezer. Negative, or sorry, 26 degrees, constant temperature, 26 degrees, 13 hours. I got 3 10-minute breaks and 1 30-minute break throughout my whole shift. And I was in a 26 degree freezer for all 13 hours. But there is a part of the factory, chat, where the chicken gets frozen. This is called the blast freeze, right? Now, the blast freeze is a very special area because the blast freeze, you can only be allowed inside it by law. American law states that you can only be inside a blast freezer for an hour and 15 minutes before you need to come out. So what that meant was that every night there was a rotation where all the boys had to work the blast freeze. So nobody got away. Nobody got away from the blast freeze. Everybody had to do it. And so, like, I would be slinging chicken through a wall all night for these orders that were going out like crazy. Somebody come tap me on the shoulder. They'd be like, "You're on the blast freeze." Then I'd have to go into the blast freeze. I'd be in there for an hour and 15 minutes, chat. When I came out, there would be icicles on my eyebrow, icicles on my beard, icicles just everywhere there could be icicles. There'd be ice formations on my eyelashes. It was crazy, bro. But that wasn't the most brutal thing about the job. The most brutal thing about that job was we sat down and did the math. And on a nightly basis, over the course of a 13-hour shift, I would put, by myself, I would put like 400 to 450, 100,000 pounds of chicken through a wall. Like, we sat down and did the math for the actual lifting. Like, how much poundage? What is the poundage? How many pounds are we putting through the wall? I would put, again, 400 to 450,000 pounds of chicken through a wall a night. And that's one lane. There were 8 lanes side by side. I'm one guy, right? It's crazy. They would put out so much chicken a night. And I was just one guy. You know what I mean? And I was a beast, though. Listen, I was a fucking tank, son. I will say that. I was very fit. But I didn't have time for anything. I didn't have time for my son. I didn't have time for anything, dude. It was crazy. You can't live like that. You can't sustain life like that in a single income household where you have a homemaker at home to take care of the family. Maybe you can do that. But even then, you're not seeing your family very often. You know what I mean? You're working all the time and then you're sleeping. What are you doing now, if you don't mind me asking? You're looking at it. I primarily take care of my family. I cook dinner for them every night. I take care of the house. I take care of my son. I've met women, moved in with them. They've had kids. I've had kids. We've created a little family. I've tried the whole family unit thing. Just, I would rather live at home with my family and take care of my family. My family family. Right? Than to go find a woman who may or may not decide that she doesn't love me at some point or something. You know what I mean? Like, people are fickle, but like my mom's always going to be my mom. You know what I'm saying? So I would rather cook my mother and my grandmother dinner every night than try to find a woman who may or may not choose to stay in a relationship. I mean, you know what I mean? That even if you get married, they may decide to leave. Like, statistically speaking, and I hate to say it, but over 80% of every divorce is initiated by females. Yet it is the female is the driving force for why people get married. You know, guys aren't the ones who want to get married. You know what I mean? So if you're pressured from a female to get married, but then 80% of every divorce is initiated by a female, it seems like you're set up for failure. And it's been some of my personal experience that personally, guys, I'd rather just take care of my family. I mean, I've got a great son. I've got a great mama. I've got a great grandma. I've got a great family. You know what I mean? I'd rather just take care of them. I don't need a piece of paper to show a woman I care for. Word up. Straight up, guys. Absolutely. Good environment for the kid. Absolutely. He said, respect. Not saying that there's not good reasons to initiate those divorces, because men are dogs. But it is what it is. Yo, a 20 bomb? Yo, holy shit, man. Thank you so much, dude. Dude. Nevaeus, thank you so much, man. That is amazing, bro. Thank you so much, dude. The fucking goat, that's right, dude. Holy shit. Yo, man, I appreciate it so much, man. I appreciate it so much. Thank you so much for the support to the channel. And I'm glad that you're having a good time here. It means the world to me. Really, it does. For sure, man. Much love to you, man. Thank you so much. You will not be forgotten here in this channel. No, sir. Thank you for the support. My family thanks you, too. So, the idea, chat, is that we're now going to dig our path down. And we're going to go past... We're going to go past the cavern two levels, and we're going to stop there. And that's going to be the first thing that we do. I'm a woman, and I would take a lot of convincing to agree to marriage, personally. Ooh! Well, you're a rare orchid, if you will, or a rare flower. Personally, it would have to be incredibly important to my partner, and I would have to be madly in love. I agree completely. Yeah, I totally believe it's not a guy thing. Maybe it's, you know, not a guy thing. Maybe it's a lot of people don't want to be married anymore. Maybe the institution of marriage has changed over the past 50 years and it's not the same thing that it used to be. It used to be about lifelong partnerships. It used to be a lifelong commitment. And now it's just, you know, if you're in love, then stay. And if you're not in love, go. You know what I mean? So it's like wishy-washy. There definitely is a demographic of females, I'm sure, that don't want to be married either. So yeah, definitely, as I was on that. I've been engaged before, but it didn't work out. I'm much happier just dating now. Dude, I gotta be honest. I've only ever been engaged. I've never been married. But I have, you know, maintained a house, a big house, and had, you know, I was with a woman who had two kids, plus I had a kid. So, you know, that's a five-person house. You know what I mean? Like, I've done long-term relationships like that. I've done, you know, dated a lot of women with kids over the years because I am a single parent, so... Naturally, women with children, if the dad's not around, they're like, okay, this guy is prime dad material. He's a single dad. So it just happens that, like, most of the women I date are single moms. It just happened that way. But, it, you know, a lot of times, again, they just don't, it just don't work out. What's up? Did you bring? I didn't bring any wine down.
The big white box up the stairs.
Yes.
Did you bring it down?
I didn't. I will grab it right now, though.
I would appreciate it. I don't think I can manhandle it down the stairs.
No, you don't have to manhandle it. Are you wanting a glass of wine?
Yeah.
Okay, I'll go get it for you.
Thank you.
Yep. So anyways, chat, I would rather, if I'm going to take care of a female, it's going to be the females who love me unconditionally. And the only females who love men unconditionally are mothers and grandmothers and daughters. Also dated a girl with a daughter for like 4 years, so I've had experience of being the father figure, which is good, but it hurts so bad to lose. Oh, dude, I don't want to talk about it. I don't want to talk about how tragic it is not to be able to speak to those kids after you spent such a long time trying to be dedicated to being their father. I don't want to fucking talk about it. It makes me angry. But I know I did right by him, and that's the point that matters. Anyways, I'm going to go get this wine for my mom. Lots of truth bombs in chat this morning. That's hilarious. Yeah, it really is, man. Yeah, man. Okay. The blatant nope. It just, you know, it's not that I don't want to talk about the tragedy of, like, not having consistent parents in a kid's life, but like after the relationship ends, you build a bond with the family and then you're never able to see him again. And so you have like these people that you used to be like super close with that end up being strangers. And it's sad because, you know, there's not a lot of situations where parents are supposed to become strangers. Cavern floor. It was 18. Okay, I don't know if it goes lower than this. I'm also the kid of a single mom. I've been single for a year and a half. I don't really think about it much. I've had long periods of being single, like several years, but then I've also been in like super long relationships, so I prefer the way that it is now. Okay, so this goes from here down to 18, which is here, and if we go up, we can see that, okay, yeah, it's just above where, that's what we wanted to do. Because I knew if I did it over here, it was going to end up over here, and then the amount of space I have on the edge is limited. Where building the ramp down over here kind of feels like it's right in the center of the map. I am going to go ahead and go to Pets and Livestock. We are going to train some war dogs. And we're going to slaughter some animals, but not yet. Really, what I need to do is I need to dig out this hole. Did I designate the fourth miner? Yeah, I did. And I've got everybody mining. So really, it's a matter now of, oh, dude, thank you so much for the sub. Why did the sound go off? Bro, why aren't the subs going off? Thank you so much, Nevaeus. I really appreciate it. The two gift subs. What do you prefer, subs or donos? You being here is simply enough. Anything that you choose to do beyond that is a blessing, and I appreciate it. But chat. Why, oh, why did my alerts not go off? Excuse me, alerts. Oh, maybe alerts get... It's because there was 20... It would still be playing. Nevaeus, you broke the... You broke it. You gifted too many subs. That's hilarious. Yeah. No, I didn't even turn it off either. Like, it's still on. You gifted so many subs, it stopped the sub alert from going off because there was just so many of them. Thank you for the incredible support. I know you guys don't really keep track of this. I mean, I do. But just so you know, I want to go in here and just get the numbers real quick. Analytics. Overview. So, we dropped. Today was the first... Holy shit, there it is. Nevaeus, thank you so much for the 24 gift subs. Avi, thank you so much for the 2 gift subs. Thank you, guys. It does work. Thank you, guys. It's just me. I broke it for me. You did. You gifted so many, it doesn't work when you gift anymore. I bet if you get it like 20 minutes, well, you know, don't give, you know what I mean, if you don't want to, but if you waited a while and tried it again, it might work. But it's probably just a timeout because there's so many of them and it can't just play them over and over. That might be a feature of OBS or a feature of Streamlabs. Either way, it's working. Dude, that's one of my favorite quotes of all time. Okay, so, no, you don't have to. No, I'm just saying that it's probably timed out. And if you're wondering why it didn't work, it'd probably work later. Oh my God. Holy shit, dude. Oh my God, dude. Jesus Christ, man. All right, listen. All right. Let me do what I can. I can do that. Wait, did I do the wrong name? Niveust. Niveust. Yeah, you're a VIP. Okay, I can make you a VIP. And listen. All I can say is, listen, if you ever want to play a video game or something, like, join the Discord, you know? You know what I mean? That's all I can say, man. Thank you so much. Like, I don't... Like, that's a lot, and I appreciate it. So, thank you for supporting the channel. If you, you know what I mean? If you ever need anything, let me know. For the kitties and the chicken pot pies, we appreciate it. We appreciate it. Thank you. Thank you so much, man. I really, really appreciate the generosity. Mutant Orchid, thank you so much for the 100 biddies. I appreciate you so much. There is no level beyond the highest level. I think you should be the expedition leader. Nevaeus, thank you so much for the support, man. Again, hit me up on Discord if you ever need me, and you'll always be a VIP here, man. Thank you so much for the incredible generosity. I'm broke, but there, I appreciate it. It's all Gucci, enjoy. Man, thank you so much, brother. I appreciate it. All right, so the best that I can do is really just show play for you guys. So I'm gonna go ahead and start it up because we've got the dig order out to the 18th floor and we know that there's a cavern bottom here. We know there's a cavern bottom here. So I'm gonna go ahead and let the boys get digging. Oh guys, I wanted to tell you. So when we started the stream, we've almost doubled the amount of subs in the channel from just the homie Nevaeus has almost doubled our subs, along with help from a lot of other people too. Don't get me wrong, but that's pretty crazy. Yo, Seesaw, welcome to the stream. Yeah, we're on a new fort. Yep. And, we're just letting the, we're just letting them go. Letting them go. Marble almost right away. Or no, that's limestone. Tetrahedrite? Rename my minor dwarf to Nevaeus with a T? Should I just rename them all Nevaeus? Just every dwarf that we get from now on, just rename them all. We are Legion. What biome are you in? Barren. I think it was Barren. Yeah, there's no trees. Don't think there is. Oh, we got 3 trees. Barren, calm. Yeah. I think what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna let these trees sprout other trees. It looks like there's some saplings around here that'll grow, but I probably won't murder these trees. I gotta find a way to do trees. The trees, you can make beds. CMD Orchid to Nevaeus 3. Okay. It's hilarious. What? Holy shit! This guy! It's from earlier? That's hilarious, dude! Jesus, man! Thank you so much, man! Holy cow, dude! Okay. Is it... What's up?
I have like 10 minutes
out. What?
I have 10 minutes left.
You were out with Wicket for 10 minutes when the ball broke, so no, you don't. Streamlabs is finally coming back to life, it seems. Streamlabs finally coming back to life. So this was Nevaeus 3. What was the other one? Smooth sailing. A level 5 hype train, hell yeah! Rename the expedition leader, okay. Is that everybody? Did I miss anybody? I think everybody's subbed now. I'm pretty sure everybody is now subbed. You've been streaming for 52 months? So there's a long history with me in streaming, chat. Story time. I started out making affiliate as a Hearthstone player, and I've actually made it to Legendary on Hearthstone, but about 6 months in, and I had like an average viewer of like 10 to 15, so I mean, I could have kept playing Hearthstone from the beginning, and I would have done fine. The problem is, my heart wasn't in Hearthstone, because you have to buy into Hearthstone. Every 3 months, you have to spend like $200. It's like clockwork, and I just don't have the money to invest. Yo, Bert, gifted a sub to Nightbot? Yo, Bert, you're hilarious. You're hilarious, Bert. You are fucking genius. Oh my god, dude, that shit is fucking hilarious. He gifted Nightbot a sub! Nightbot's the real OG sporter, Bert knows. Yeah, there is another Bert. You know, guys, I don't know if you knew this or not, but I also, in one of my names, there is a Bert. I'm also a Bert. But yes, Oh my god, you gifted Streamlabs a subscription?! What the fuck, man? You guys are too much. You guys are too much, man. Thank you so much. I appreciate you guys. Oh my god, you gifted me a sub? Oh, you gifted the original Cancel TV a sub to Cancy ITV after I sent him a message and he said that he would sell his name for $1 million? Are you kidding me? That's such a slap in the face. Yo, what a fucking ballin' move. This man literally said, I'll sell you Cancel TV for $1 million. I was like, whoa, I'm not ever gonna be able to do that. Dude, so you gifted him a sub to my channel. That's hilarious. Now he'll get a notification so he knows I'm still streaming. That's hilarious. That is hilarious. Nevaeh gifted a tier 1 sub to the Elite Jellyfish. Nice. Figma tips, don't sell your account for less than a mil. There you go, right? The guy is either an a-hole or a 12. Yeah. I'm gonna gift him a sub now every month now that I know that. That would be so fucking funny, dude! Oh, dude, that's hilarious. Guys, thank you so much for the support. I appreciate you guys so much. It means a great deal to me that you guys even come and hang out with me. Really, that is the biggest thing. So thank you. I appreciate it. My family appreciates it. We appreciate you guys. So thank you for all the love. I appreciate you. Especially, to see it. Especially thank you, Nevaeh. I really, really appreciate it. Like 45 subs. That's just, it's incredible. Thank you so much. Oriental Habit, thank you so much for the follow. You are follower number 917, and I appreciate you so much for supporting my content. Thank you. I really appreciate it. Like I said, if you ever need me, hit me up on Discord, for sure. Yeah, there's really not much else I can do. Good luck. I hope this fort falls in 3 hours. I hope it does, too. It's been a while since we just lost straight up really early. But we are going down. 18 is the cavern layer, folks. 18. We're going to pop in the cavern layer in just a moment. Okay, hold the phone. This means that we bypass the cap. Oh, dear. Nevance. Thank you for... Listen. Thank you for gifting Leah a sub. That was very nice of you. Leah probably has more channel points than anyone here other than my mom. Or Johnny. Yeah, he just stops by to troll me these days, but literally, like... Thank you so much for the subs, man. I really appreciate it. Yeah. It's a fuck you gift sub, then. Well, no, I was just saying, like, Leah shows so much support. Like, just hanging out and being a part of the channel. Like, back when I would have nobody watching, you know who'd be in here? Leah would be in here. Every day. Every day. We will always appreciate you here. Only have 100K? That's crazy. That's still a lot. That's an insane amount. And you've redeemed a bunch of shit. Only 100K, right? Thank you so much, Neveus, for gifting the sub to Wolf. Thank you, thank you, thank you. It's like anybody who chats. They're not subbed, Neveus is like, not on my watch. Okay, so we know the cavern layer is here. So this is a problem. We need to go up and scope this out. We're going to do some sonar here. Workshops. We're going to go farming. We're going to go farm plot. And we're going to scope this out because it's right below here. Down we go. Okay. So that's where the cavern floor is. So what that probably means, and this is my deduction here, if that's the cavern floor, then there's probably maybe a lake that's on this floor, and maybe it goes down another floor, right? And then we want to build two floors down after that. And just, that's probably good. That's elevation 14. We want to get to 14. That's the key. So let's keep digging this out. Down one more. 16. 15. And then this will go down to 14. And then this will get dug out here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Then we do our... Actually, we're not doing that standard entrance. I want to do the entrance. I think I'm going to shave this off. I do want there to be almost immediately. I want there to be the trade depot. So the trade depot is going to go right here. So we'll come down here. It goes one space forward and then the trade depot's here. This will be walls all through here, but there will be a path through the walls here. Just like the last base. It was a good design. I think this, however, is going to be a three-wide path for the actual base. So this will kind of be the little courtyard area where they'll come in. And then I want to leave some space on the outside to do everything. So I need to find out where the edge is first. There's the edge. And then I want to cut off... Like, a lot of it. I don't need it to be... You know what we need to do, chat? Before I do anything else, I need to designate the stairwell, the main stair. So, the last time we put the main stair off to the side. So we put the main stair off to the side, and it worked really well. And then we set up our diamond-making area right near the entrance. Because it seemed like an early game thing to do that was really good. And it worked out pretty good, except for he kept bumping into everybody. So honestly, we need to just designate a little area for him. Let's do this, a 5x5 spot. And then let's kind of choose if we want to make this the middle of a hallway. Maybe we'll do like that. So having a hallway that's one wide is bad. Yes. In fact, if you have a really super populated area that's like a main thoroughfare, you might want to even make it like five wide. So this is a hallway. Which means I want to get rid of the fancy shit on the sides. Probably get rid of... You know, we can probably keep those. That's fine. Little indents right here and here. But I do need to create the main stair. This goes down pretty far. We don't want to go all the way down. We're trying to determine where we want to put the main stair. You know what? I'm just going to put it in the same spot I did last time. It was just such a great spot. We'll do it right here. Right? And then we can... No. We're going to have to do it right here. One, two. One, two. Ooh, chat, what if I, like... You know what? I need to dig this out before I do, like, this really elaborate setup. Like, I need to see if this is even going to be workable. I think what I'm going to do for now is... dig out this and this. I'm going to dig this... I'm going to see if this is, like, a floor that can be dug out or if there's caverns here. Because if I'm doing this on a place where there's caverns, then I might be fucking myself. If you dig into a cave, can dwarves fall and die? When they're channeling down, they're channeling the tile that's in front of them. So I don't think so. But if they're channeling down and then something tries to strike them from behind and they jump out of the way, they can definitely jump into the hole. I plan with blueprints? Nice. I need to let them dig... Oh, I did this wrong. Chat, I fucked up. Goes here. Sorry, this here, then here. And here. No. Right there. And... this goes down one. This goes straight down one. Then this goes straight down one. Then this goes straight down one. Which means we don't need this dug out because it'll be dug out automatically. But this should actually line perfectly up with the base here. Anything short of perfection is irrelevant. Start again. My only two rules, never straight up or straight down. Yep. Dang, dwarves are smarter than a 12-year-old YouTube Minecrafter. That's crazy. And you say blueprints from game to game. Yeah, it's complicated, though, and I really wasn't paying attention when I watched the video on how to do it. So I really couldn't tell you exactly how it's done. But for now, we're going to dig. We're going to let this get dug out. There we go. Get him down here. Get him digging. You can. Yeah. Control R is like control record. And then it follows your mouse movements, or maybe you have to do it with the keyboard specifically. something like that, yeah. Gotta use a keyboard cursor. Yeah, it's complex. It's definitely complex. Okay, they're done. It appears as though this level is good. We know the cavern floor is right here, and we can make our way back up to that. But for now, I think we bypassed the cavern layer. Macros are a lifesaver for things like pump stack. I believe that. Yeah, having to go down, highlight everything, go back, delete one little box, two little box, three little box, four little box. Go down, highlight everything and delete it. And then you, once it's dig out, you got to go through and individually channel out alternating paths all the way up. Then you got to choose the fucking materials, especially if it's a magma safe. It has to be magma safe. Then you got to choose the materials for everyone. It's super annoying. I did a 70 tile magma pump stack in my last fort. It took a long time. I was, and by the time I got done with it, I was like, I'm fucking done with this. Yo, back scratchers are the shit, chat. Just saying. Excellent. All right. Now we're going to do some base design. I'm really going to let go with this. Like, I'm going to do it. Like, I'm going to start digging out exactly what it's going to look like in the long term, and we're going to start sectioning it off little by little. I'm going to invest, and I'm going to assume that we should be able to dig on this entire layer without running into the caverns, though I could be so wrong. Head massagers are better than back scratchers. Fight me on this. I've never used a head massager, so I don't have an opinion on it. Planning any sort of repetitive digging. Oh, like bedrooms and stuff. Yeah, yeah. It's super good for that. What's up?
I'm going to get the chicken pop. Like 40 seconds left on it.
Okay, yeah. Turn the timer off. All right, chat. So we have our first hallway. Here's the first hallway. Everything we do will be within the designations of base that looks exactly like this. Now we're going to set up our base dimension. Good job watching that timer. Hell yeah, I did. We're going, it's 31 tiles. So let's count that out. What's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30, 31. That'll be the next stair right there. Then there will be, as that branch off from that... Then we are 41 wide. So let's do this one. We really should set up a macro for this. Just to do the two hallways. We should really set up a macro for this, because counting out everyone is silly when we could just set up a macro. Is it Control R? No, that was Shift R. Control R is recording. And then how do you fit? Is it just Control R again to stop it? And is that now copied? Now, how do I bring up the... Oh, dude. I'm a tad bit confused. I've got a lot of dwarves with no job, but there is lots of jobs. Could they be doing the fortress? No idea what the heck's going wrong at this point. You need to record then save. That's right. Yeah. And I probably did it wrong. I'm just going to count it out. I'm not that good. Control R to start recording. Control R to stop. Control P to replay. Control P to replay. So like if I put my cursor right here and I went Control P, it didn't work. Okay, I don't know. I gotta save it probably and then load it from the save. Gotta use keyboard cursor. Yeah, you're definitely right. I need to use the keyboard cursor. It's recording keyboard macros. Gotcha. How do you know where the... All right, first, before we do anything else, I'm just going to save. It's because I'm paranoid as fuck. I'm gonna try to master this. Just for the sake of setting up my blocks in a more efficient manner. So, first thing I want to do is settings, game, keyboard cursor enabled, yes, done, return to game, and then we want to do control R to record, so it's now recording. Where is the keyboard for the, it's M. Do we click enter to start it, or, yes. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28. Oh, I didn't start at the right spot. Okay. Control R to stop. Nobody look. And I probably want to do it. I want to do four of them. Just control R and control R again to start again. Gotcha. Usually I start with my cursor where I want it. Okay. Look, if I wanted to start right here, right? And I did control R, was recording, I did M.
Apparently up top means making me wait another 10 minutes.
And then we're going to do, hold on 1 second, buddy. Enter. Then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30. Enter. And control R. And then, what did you say? Control S to save. Control, oh shit, what did I just save? Control L to load. Bedrooms. No.
He's making me that here.
Yeah.
And apparently there were instructions at a very small spot where I could.
So did you get the instructions?
Yeah, Mimi went up there with me. Hard. Apparently we have to wait like an hour. At the 375. I don't know.
Did you read the instructions? Or is Mimi cooking it?
Mimi just read it for me. Put it to 375. And it's for the.
So you're just waiting for the oven to preheat, then you're going to put it in. Make sure you read the instructions and see how long you're putting it in for, okay?
Mimi said about an hour.
Well, about an hour and an hour or an hour and a half is not good enough. You're going to have to say, Mimi, is it an hour or an hour and a half? 30 minutes means a difference. Because you're going to have to know exactly how long to put on the timer when you set the timer. So make sure you know, okay?
Okay.
Making sure. Well, did you read the instructions properly? Or were you...
I didn't know the right.
Well, if you were about to put something in the oven without any instructions, because we thought there were no instructions on it, Mimi found the instructions.
Oh, no. I let Mimi know.
But it wasn't a good idea for you to put it in the oven at that temperature, was it? For the time period that we talked about? Because the instructions said differently?
You just told me to, like...
Right, but no, we were wrong off kilter. Do you understand? Right from the start, we were incorrect. Yeah. Because there were instructions that you missed. All that other shit's out the window. It doesn't fucking matter. You got it? Like, all that other stuff doesn't matter. We didn't read the instructions properly. We need to set the instructions up. We need to set it up so that it follows the instructions. Yeah. So if Mimi come up and saw that you were doing something incorrectly, she probably corrected you. That's what I would have done. If the instructions say something different, then yeah, you get corrected. But it's not like Mimi came up there with the intent of like being mean to you. He corrected your mistake. Careful how you perceive things. You might mistake malice for not malice. I don't think Mimi was... You know, if I come upstairs and you were cooking something incorrectly and I knew you were going to make a mistake, I would probably be like, oh, wait, don't do that. You know what I mean? But it makes sense. It's not... It doesn't sound off character. But I'll tell you what we're not going to do. We're not going to come downstairs and complain about Mimi being mean. Because I don't partake in talking shit about other family members. So if you want to do that, you're going to have to find somebody else. Okay? Gotcha. Okay. Control save. Control S. And then let's just make this North Hall. Enter. Now we want to control load. North Hall. Enter. And then... Control load? Yeah, that's what I did, I thought. Control P to play. Okay. I probably need to do one going down. So Control L. North Hall goes from south to north. I need one going from north to south also. So I'm going to escape out of that, and I'm going to do... We're going to do Control R to record. Then we're going to do M. Then we're going to use the cursor to dig out 31 tiles. So enter to start it, and then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30, 31. Enter. Control R. Then Control S to save. This is north, south. Enter. Okay, now we're going to need to make... Maybe he's hacking you for pizza. Socialing. He's definitely on the red team. Alright, let's do another one. Starting... Control R. And then we're going to go... I don't see the cursor. I'm just going to Control R and then Control R again. What the fuck just happened? Need to set this to F2 immediately. F2. Okay, perfect. How do I say your name? K.I. Taurus. Hey, Taurus. Kai Taurus. It's good to see you. Welcome, man. I don't know how, but I beat 4 stacks of Wurzag with a single elf army. That's fucking... It's because you're a badass. That's why. Okay, so we set the... So we go Control R, then we go M to mine, then we go over here, and we press enter, and we go up, up, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30, 31, 32, 33, 34, 35, 36, 37, 38, 39, 40, 41. Control R. Control S to save. We're going to name it East to West. East West. Enter. And we're going to do another one. Control R. M to mine. Yep, starting there. We're going to press enter. Then we're going to go up to. And then we're going to go over 41. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 31, 32, 33, 34, 35, 36, 37, 38, 39, 40, 41. And we'll do Control R, then Control S to save, and this is going to be east-west. Okay, so now I should have all the proper hallways, except for I don't know how to fucking start them. Like when I press Control Start, what dictates where they start? I have no idea. Do they start where the keyboard cursor started? If that's the case, then I have no idea. Well, yeah, he's talking about Warhammer. Okay, how the fuck am I doing this? Well, we know that there is going to be a staircase here. So we can go ahead and... Well, this is 41, right? God, I know that I just did this, but I want to check it. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20... 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30, 31, 32, 33, 34, 35, 36, 37, 38, 39, 40, 41, 42. One of my macros is wrong. The macro is wrong. So we could still use the macro to make it and just slice an edge off of it. But I want to see if it works. But I'm going to go up here. And I'm going to click M, and I'm going to go right here, and then I'm going to go Control L to load, and we're going to go east to west, and click Enter, and then Control P to play. Oh, I did it! Yo! That's so cool! Yo, chat! I just spit everywhere.
Set it for an hour and 20.
An hour and 20 minutes. Gotcha. Okay, put the cursor right here. Press Control L to load. Oh, I didn't have, east to west? I need west to east. I need to do a west to east one again, it looks like. Which is fine. We'll escape out of that. Get out of there. And we'll do Control R to start. And then we'll do M to mine. We'll go down. And then we'll press Enter. And we already mapped this out. And measured it so we know it's right. And we just click Enter. Then we go Control R to stop the recording. Then we go Control S to save it. And this is from west to east. West, east, west, east. So we save that as west, east. Then to verify that it works, we're going to click right here. Then we're going to go Control L to load. We're going to do west, east, enter, Control P to play, Control P. What happened? What happened here? It appears as though I've done something incorrect. Let's do Control P. Okay, so how do I determine where it's going to shoot it out at? I feel like I may have done this. Maybe I did it wrong. So, like, if the... Let's do M. So Control P to play. Okay, so it where the keyboard cursor starts is important. Okay. From south to north, where did that one start? Let's go Control L to load. Let's go North Hall, because that was from the south to the north. That was the one. Now I should just be able to do Control P. I'm going to get out of here, though. I'm going to click M. I'm going to move the keyboard thing right there. Then I'm going to click Control L. And I'm going to go North Hall Then Control P. Why, hello there! Let me mute my mic, give me 1 second. The Biggins. Oh no. Did the inevitable happen to Fort number 10? How'd it go down? No, actually we retired it. Control play. Do I need to not have anything control play? Did I not load it? Control load. North Hall. Enter. Control play. Nope, that didn't record anything. Okay, so we need to do another one. We want it to start right here. So M, we want it to start right here. So now we want to do control record starting here. Then we're going to go up. Oh no. Well, it's going to make a silly error where it goes up and then comes down and then it'll make it. Whatever. That's fine. Enter and then control R to stop it. And then control S to save it. And this is North Hall. Which hopefully overwrites the other North Hall. Now to start it up here, I want to click M, move here. I want to go Control L to load. Then I want to click North Hall, and then I want to click Control Play. That's it. All right. This is good. Yeah, chat. We've got macros set up. Our blocks, chat. Our blocks. That's cool. All right, so how big do we want the entryway girth to be? Because right now it goes to the edge, and we know we wanted a lot of space. So I think what I'm going to do, we're going to go down a level here, down a level here, down a level here, down a level here, down a level here. And then over here, we're going to do the same thing. Down a level here. 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 Same thing here. Down a level 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 here. And then I kind of want to clean this up a bit. Make it look a little nicer. Got to be on mining for that. Put these in here. Oh, it looks right. Yeah, man, it's gonna be great. And we'll do stairs right here, going down. I am actually paused right now.
Oh.
So that's why, yeah. Wig. Okay, so a couple things, chat. We want to leave a space on the edge. So let's just say 10 tiles from every edge, we leave ourselves 10 tiles of space. So let's go ahead and delete back 10 tiles. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. And then we'll cut down from there. We know we want to go down this way. And we want to go to like the middle of this block, right? We're going to give ourselves the extra space by, instead of bringing it, let's see, before We actually had more room in the top space here before. There's more room over here this time. So it's definitely going to be longer. But we can still bring it up through here. That's fine. Most importantly, though, we want to come through the center. So we want there to be a space, like a no-go space. But you can't really put it in the middle anywhere, so it's kind of got to go in an awkward place. Let me just, for the sake of my own happiness, carve out the staircases so they look right. And do the same thing down here. All right, this looks right. It feels right. So, initial storage area. Gonna have to be right here, I think. Wood carving here. One mechanic workshop. One stone worker workshop. One stone carver workshop. Or maybe two stone cutters, crafts, and a mechanic. And two carpentry workshops. Gonna have to go in this area. That's gonna be my starting area. This is going to be the place where I dump everything. But before I do that, I really do kind of want to calculate out exactly where my pathway is going to go. So we could come up to maybe even right here at a path. I want to dig this back out right through here. So now this will ultimately come over here. This will be the big corner. So the last, okay, so it's two tiles taller than it used to be. And chat, it's gonna be much longer. It's just a little bit taller and it's gonna be much longer. So it's just 2, 1, 2, then begins this, which then goes onto this, we then use to make our staircase. All right. So, what you should do is put all the intersections on the phone so you never have to read them off the box. I would buy that app. That would be, yeah, that's smart. I think how do I want to do this? Chat, do I feel like I have enough space? Like, do we have enough space for a big corner atom smasher, a flood hallway? I feel like no. I feel like the answer to the question is no, it needs to be longer. So we're going to continue on. And, you know, I guess down through here we could try to house Forgotten Beasts down through here. But then again, I want one large section of hallway to be the flood hallway. Right? So if from here up to here over to here is the Atom Smasher, and the flood hallway. Huh. You know, the flood hallway doesn't need to be so gigantic. We might need to do another turn. What if we did something like this? Like, say the flood hallway started That seems right. Maybe we could even do it a little longer like that. And so we got a nice long flood hallway, a huge corner smasher, and now we need to route some, like a gauntlet, really. It needs to be like a pathway for a dragon, specifically for a dragon. And me and my grandfather talked about what this area was going to need to look like. But ultimately, it's going to need to be a very special area. So if this is all flood hallway here, and this is all Atom Smasher through here, you know, chat, why the fuck do we not want to just go to the edge of the map? If it's all going to be an Atom Smasher anyways, like if the whole thing is going to be one big Atom Smasher, why not go to the edge of the map? We're like not utilizing space. Well, I guess it's not really a big deal. It's good to have some extra space on either side so you have room to work with just in case. But I do want to set up an area for a dragon or a forgotten beast that breathes fire. I need to do that. So, if I was going to set up a dragon hallway, I want it to be like 3x3s like this. Okay? And then there's a long wall of fortifications that starts here, goes here, here, here. Realistically, there just needs to be an area on the other side of this wall. So it goes three up. And if we wanted to do... How many wide do we want this to be at the top? Do we want it to do like this? Or no, we want it to be like this. Right? And then have it come down like this. Then it comes back down and goes straight. I guess I want to also dig this out. And this out. Oh, I didn't mean to do that though. Okay. So then... So, do you just want to like, you just want to make foundations out of these three right here? And then if he's standing here, he can shoot out this way. If he's standing here, he can shoot out this way. If he's standing right here, he can shoot out this way, right? So the idea is that the enemies will start to mob around this corner. He'll shoot at him. They'll start a fire. Oh, I need to clear this out area above his head. Above his head has to be clearer. So this has to be a channel out area. I can't forget about this. I'm going to mark it now. And this up here, again, is going to be another channel out area. I'm going to mark it now. So we want to go up. How many levels do you think? One, two, maybe three levels up to catch the smoke? Yes.
What is a Cheshire grin?
It looks like this. Like a mischievous grin. A really big mischievous grin.
Oh, that's it.
Yeah. Okay, so we have an area cut out for a dragon or a forgotten beast that breathes fire. Either way, we have an area. And let's say, where do we want to do the cage trap hallway? Also, where is... Chat, I'm about to put this up here. I feel like this would fit better up there. I really don't want it down here. I'll tell you what I'd like to do, chat. I'm just gonna do it. I'm gonna pick all this shit out. And then we're gonna go forward here to the edge. Right there. And then again, we're gonna use the edge of the map. I like doing that last time. Alright, so there is the edge of the map, the true edge. Which means we only have to have an Atom Smasher that goes from here to here and like from here to like up here. Which means we totally could do a dragon area up here. Also, alternatively, we could snake in a huge cage hallway as well. So let's just do like this. Let's delete this. We know where that we want it to end. So let's see where it begins. So let's say our first... We leave a space open. And then we go from here. So we go up one, up one, up one. Wow, it fit perfectly. That's crazy, actually. I am going to clear this out and this right here. So, like, as they come into this area, they just start getting bombarded with fire down the hallway. And then, I guess, again, I'm going to have to deconstruct one more tile wide on each side. So the hallway's a little bit bigger to blow fire through. And then these four tiles here, I guess, will be designated for these four tiles right here between will be fortifications. And honestly, chat, I don't know. Should we make the room any bigger than that? Yeah, we should make it so we can fire sideways. Like, if this is a fortification here, I want them to be able to shoot sideways through here. So it needs to be probably six wide. We'll do six wide, three deep. It's the tiny forgotten beast hole. So again, we want to go back over here. We'll go up here. We'll delete this because we know we're not using this anymore. Okay, chat. My timer is going off. As you can see, we've got our fire hallway, our corner Atom Smasher, our flood hallway, and then we're going to do the last bit of the gauntlet. It's going to be the cage hallway. Or maybe we should put the... Chat, I'm going to figure out a way to put the cage hallway in a diamond that goes the other way, some way. Echo, turn off. Okay. I do have to go help my grandfather, though. I will. The good news is I don't have to cook dinner tonight. My son is volunteered and Mimi's helping him. So I just need to go for maybe 15, 20 minutes and I'll be back. So it shouldn't be a super long AFK break. I'm not going to stop the stream for it. We'll be back in a few minutes. Listen, Neveus, thank you so much for the subs, man. Thank you so much. And everybody else who gifted, Bert, everybody who contributed to the Hype Train, Orchid, thank you so much. Obby, thank you so much. Thank you for all the follows, guys. Really appreciate it. Thank you for the anonymous gift sub earlier as well, guys. I'm going to go AFK for a while. Have a good 1 minute. Got you, brother. I appreciate you guys. I'll be back in like 20 minutes. Thank you so much. Yeah, we'll be right back.